Aladdin Creations.
Hello friends, welcome to another video of Aladdin Creations. My name is Kavindu. I have seen a lot of my viewers asking me to do a videos about malaria topic. So I hope this time video is serious about this malaria topic. What is malaria? Malaria parasite life cycle. How to diagnose malaria at medical laboratory. How to identify and differentiate malaria parasites on Brandismia and malaria Brandismia identification training courses. So guys, let's start video number one of this malaria video series. What is malaria? Malaria is one of serious and fatal mosquito-borne disease caused by protozoan parasite. These protozoa belong to Plasmodium species, mainly Plasmodium vivax, Plasmodium falciparum, Plasmodium ovale, Plasmodium malariae, and most commonly the vector is of an anopheline mosquito. Even though it is considered a life-threatening disease, malaria can be cured if diagnosed and treated quickly and correctly. Incidence and prevalence. Malaria occurs all over the world, but the prevalence is prominent in tropics and subtropics where are closer to equator. However, prevalences depend on mainly on climate factors such as temperature, humidity and rainfall pattern, etc. Even within tropics and subtropics, transmission does not occur at very high altitude during cold season and in deserts. In 2017, an estimated 219 million cases of malaria occurred worldwide and 435,000 of fatal cases were reported. Children, travelers to endemic areas, pregnant mothers, immunosuppressive people are the most vulnerable groups of having malaria. Symptoms. Common symptoms include fever, shaking chills, and flu-like illness. Sometimes these can be absent. Transmission. The major route of transmission is a bite of an Plasmodium infected mosquito. In additionally, it occurs when an infected mother transmits parasites to their child during pregnancy, before or during delivery. This is called as congenital malaria. And also, another way of getting infected with malaria is transfusion of infected blood. But at present, it is very rare as blood products undergo malaria screening test prior to transfusion. Treatment. Treatment of malaria depends on several factors such as Plasmodium species, which is responsible, severity of disease, prevalent area, pregnancy state, etc. As much as possible, it is necessary to start treatment process and prompt and correct drug regime make it curable easily. Prevention. Now the malaria control programs are available, especially in endemic areas, to reduce malaria cases and death and prevent transmission. As it is mosquito-borne disease, mosquito eradication is the best way to prevention. In addition to refrain from traveling to malaria endemic areas, use of necessary precaution to avoid mosquito bites are some of applicable measures. Well friends, I hope you guys enjoy this video and gain knowledge about this malaria disease. Anyway, in my next video, I hope to discuss with you the life cycle of this malaria parasites. So guys, don't forget to subscribe my YouTube channel and bell icon to update with more medical laboratory science and medical related videos like this. Thank you.